Hey everyone, I'm Aliena and welcome back to my channel. You folks have been asking me what is the tool that I've been using to take those good, pretty notes? And the answer is Notion. So for around 1 or 2 years ago, I've been moving all my notes and a lot of my files to Notion for two reasons. Well, first, because it is online and it connects the documents together. And the second reason is that it just looks good. And I think it would be a good idea for me to give you a little bit of tour of what my Notion workspace looks like, plus a little bit of tutorial of how I build those pages. This is how the home looks like for my Notion. And here's the main section. So everything in this section is a separate page by itself. And right now you're just seeing the titles of those pages and the emojis that represent the pages. Three sections: work, life, and others. And for work, I have lifelong learning, which is a page that consists of my notes for my online courses. And then I have a page called my UI UX world, where I put all the work documents related to my work. And then get it out there, it's just my YouTube project, YouTube planning space. My cool projects have all the random things I've worked on that didn't really turn out to be a major thing. And then learning from events are just notes I've taken from random events. Now into the middle section, life, I have everything piano, learn a thing, stand-up comedy. I've tried to write one little piece of stand-up comedy per week, mainly in Chinese though, but I really want to incorporate more humor into my channel, so that's something I've been trying to work on. And menu represents pretty much what I want to cook for the week, and I'm still working on it. Now onto the other side, others. I have everything, legal documents I need to keep, health insurance stuff. An archive is a place where I put everything that I've created but didn't end up using. Now going to the bottom section, which is also the final section of my homepage, it's a huge calendar. This is a place where I take daily notes or build daily to-do list or Kanban board. And it has a cute name. It's called Today is the Perfect Day. Why? Because I always want to move things to tomorrow. And this is a sentence that reminds myself that today is the perfect day to do whatever you want to do. And as you can see, for this entire month, I've only created 1, 2, 3, 5 daily notes. I used to be very OCD, like when it comes to those bullet journal, when it comes to a calendar like this, I want to fill the calendar. And it just never works out because it feels like work. And that's why I've intentionally told myself I'm only going to build a page if I feel like using Notion to plan my day for the day. And it's okay to have those gaps in between days. Another reason is that I have a separate calendar for my work as well, so those are pretty much all filled. And let me just give you a quick peek of what's inside. For every single daily note, it's usually just a to-do list. And I will just throw every random thing that comes to my mind into this Kanban board kind of to-do list. So things like taking out trash, having breakfast, stretch, and definitely like shoot my YouTube video, get back to that email that I've forgotten for 3 weeks. And it's just so interesting when I start to throw everything in there, because I realized that there's always more housework or life work compared to work. So I have full respect for housewives or stay-at-home daddies that take care of their baby or home or life as a full-time job. It is a full-time job. It's probably more than a full-time job. I hope you've been liking my tour so far, and I know not all of you have been used Notion before, so I will give a quick tutorial of how I built 3 of my pages and show you a little bit more of what's inside. Let's start from the homepage. To access Notion, please go to notion.so or use the link in the description. To create a new page on Notion, hit the plus sign on the left sidebar. Then create a title. Click add icon to choose an emoji to represent this page. For now, I'll choose the female astronaut emoji. Then click add cover to add a cover. Hover over it and click change cover in order to change the cover. You can select unsplash if you don't have a cover of your own. And I will search minimal and use this desert picture for now. You can always reposition it and you can drag it to the place you want it to be. Looks nice now. Now if you want to write something, simply just click the first line and then start writing. But for now, I need a different style, so I will delete these, and then I will hit the slash sign on the keyboard and then type in quote. In this way, if I paste in something here, it will look like a quote. and then I'll hit return twice to start a new paragraph. Let's hit slash sign again and then choose heading 1 for this time, which is the largest font size, and then I'll put in work. Now return, and then hit the dash sign twice. This will give a nice division look. Now I'll create a new page by hitting the slash sign and then select page. And now I'm just going to give a title for the page, so lifelong learning. And of course, give it a nice icon. So I'm going to look up books because it is about learning, so stereotypically a book. Now if we go back, we can see that we can see this page right here. And if we click it, we'll see that page of lifelong learning. So this is how we create a new page on Notion. And for now, I'm just going to create the rest of the pages for this work category. And whenever you're ready, let's hit the slash sign again and then create another heading 1. And this time, let's put in life. Hit the dash sign twice to give that nice division line. And now I'm just going to put in more pages, but this time for the life category. And finally, I will do the same for the final category that's named under others. So I will create another heading 1, another dash line, and then another few pages. Please forgive me for using a lot of dot 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 to save time here. Now, in order to move things around, let's first select where we want to move and then click that 6 dot. Drag that to the place that we want this section to be. And again, things usually won't work the way you want it to be in the first trial. So sometimes we will have to select things around again and to drag them back to where they're supposed to be, just like what I'm doing here right now. And now I'm selecting everything under the others category and then using the 6 dot, dragging it right beside life. And ta-da, work, life, others. This is how I created the second section of this page. Now for the last section, I'm going to hit slash again and then search up calendar. This way, we can create a great calendar for this section. And always hit new database because we are creating a new calendar, not using an old calendar. And we can give it a title if we want to. And for now, I'm just going to name it under calendar. And clearly this calendar is not at the place where I want it to be. So I'm going to hover over the top left corner of calendar, use that 6 dot, drag that to the bottom of the page so that it takes up the entire page. I actually still prefer having another heading 1 on top of my calendar. So I'm going to add another heading 1 and then give it a cheesy line. Today is the perfect day. And then we'll drag this entire sentence to the place that I want it to be. That is directly above the calendar. And here we go. It looks like we have the big structure already finished for this entire homepage. I'm just going to do a little bit of adjustment here and there. For the calendar, if you want to change the look, you can hit the 3 dots on the top right. And then, for example, you can hit layout and deselect show database title. Right now, it just hides the name calendar. And this is the way that I prefer it to be, so I'm going to save it like this. And now we're able to use the calendar. So if you want to create a page for today, hit the plus sign, and then we can change the name. And I'm just going to change it to today's date, June 16th, 2022. Yeah, this is the day when I record this video, and I'm not sure when I'm able to finish editing and publish it. And you can use this daily page however you like it. And I will show you how I built mine in the later part of this video. And so far, we've covered everything of how I built everything on my homepage. And I hope you are liking Notion so far. So now let's move to the second section. And the next thing I would love to show you is how I take notes by Notion. So I will show you how I build this lifelong learning page and how I take notes in these pages. So here's a reminder of how my lifelong learning page look. It's pretty much just a place that I take notes for my online courses. And yeah, I've been taking a lot of online courses after graduation because, you know, I didn't choose the right major. And yeah, for example, this is my UX design course that I took from Google Certificate, from Coursera, and I have very detailed notes for every single chapter. So I usually take notes by using a point form, and I will embed the link that I found very useful to my note, which is what I'm hovering over right now. Besides that, I will also include something like screenshots, and sometimes videos or charts. Now let me show you how I created those notes. So first of all, let's go back to the homepage that we just created from the last step. And let's go to the lifelong learning page. Right now it shall be empty, but we can hit return to create a new page or write something here. Let's put in slash again, and this time search list. Then select list view. And again, let's hit new database because we're creating a new list. Now I'm going to give a title for this list. So I'm going to call it online courses. And for the rest of the pages that's named under page 1, page 2, page 3, we can open them. And of course, we can always change the name of those pages. For now, I'm going to use the course name that I've been taking. And if you want to add a new page, just hit new on the bottom of the list. And then here we go, it's a new page. Now let's pay a little bit of attention on what's underneath the title. These are the properties that we can give to every single page of the list. And we can always delete a property or edit a property. For example, I'm going to hit edit a property now and change this into a select. What this means is that I'm going to have a field where I can select from different options. So I'm going to name it status. And then I can add a status by just typing in a status. So for example, completed. If I don't like the color, I just click it again. I hover over it, click the three dots, and then change the color. Now for every single page in this list, I will always have that status property, and I can always choose between complete versus some other options that I can set up later. And now I'm giving another property name under date. So I'm going to give the date where I've started taking the course, and then the date that I stopped taking the course and finished taking the course. In order to add an end date, simply just click that end date. Right here, I just turn it on. So right now I'm just going to change the date to reflect the actual end date. And here we go. Now, if I'm actually taking note right now, I will always open it as a page, so the thing looks bigger on the screen. And because this course has a lot of chapters, I'm going to add another list view, select new database, and then name it course notes. This list view will allow me to have one page per chapter. And now I'm just putting in the title per chapter. Now let's say I'm taking the first chapter or course one. I will of course first open this page, and then I will start taking notes by typing into this page. And it will automatically look like a paragraph style, but we can always change it into, let's say, heading one. And to put a point here, I'm going to hit dash and then space. This just creates a nice bullet point. Now, if you finish writing up this sentence, if you hit return, it will automatically create another bullet point. So just keep taking good notes. Hit the tab bar on your keyboard in order to indent a bullet point. And if you want to paste in a link, simply just copy it from somewhere else and then paste it here. You can select Create Bookmark to make it look nice. Now you can have a preview of what this link is about. If you want to embed an image, my suggestion is to take a screenshot and then paste in the screenshot directly to here. And on Notion, you can always adjust the size of your screenshot. It will look pretty nice on the white background. If you want to paste in a video, you can also click Embed Video. In that way, the video will directly show on this page. And here we go. This is my video of how to become a UX designer and get your first job. And fun fact, you can also skip the ad by embedding the video into Notion. That covers the most important things we need to know when it comes to taking notes. And finally, if you want to share the notes, just click share on the top right. You can share it to website and copy the link to your friend or people who need to view this. Or you can just add their email to here so that it doesn't have to be shared on the website. And now I will show you how I use Notion to manage my time, my projects. So here's another page where I use to manage my YouTube channel. It's pretty much a place to document my ideas and also to just take notes and write scripts, putting random inspirations and details for every single one of my video. You can use the same idea for any of the project that you've been working on. It of course doesn't have to be a YouTube project, it can be a design project. And here's how I built it. Let's go back to the home that we just built and then go to the page named under My UI UX World. And then let's hit enter to create an empty new page. Hit slash and then search for board view. Please click new database. You can give the board view a title based on the projects you are working on. If you want to delete any of the card, hover over it, select the three dots button, and then click Delete. You can also hide any card without a status. Now we can change the name of each column. For now, I'm going to change them to names that are related to my UI/UX design process, such as ideation, wireframing, prototyping, etc. Now, if we need to create a new card, we simply hit plus new. We can create this card under any of the column. And now I'm just going to give a lot of name to the projects that I've been working on. And let's say if I finished the ideation stage of a project, I can always drag it to another stage. Another thing that you shall explore is hover over board view and then click add view, then select gallery, and then click done. So what this does is that it gives an entire different view of this entire field. So now we have the three projects that I created under three big cards. And if you have information in it, you can see the information within those cards using this view. You can also drag the gallery view in front of the broad view to make it the primary view of this entire field. Now let's hit add view again and let's try out the list view. Click list and then hit done. It just created a list of all the projects that we've put into the field. Now we have the gallery view, the board view, and then one more, that is the list view, right here. So let's say if we think the page is not wide enough, then we can hit the three dots on the top right and then hit full width. Now we've just put more cards into the single view and the page becomes wider. Let's apply a similar idea to the calendar we've created for our homepage. For this calendar here, let's click the date that we have for today, and then open the page as a full page, and then hit create a template. Let's open it as a page again. Let's go to the body section, hit slash, and then find another board view. Once you find the board view, hit that, and then let's select create new database. We can give our Kanban board a name, and because I'm creating a template for the daily to-do list, I would just name it under to-do list. I don't need those cards for now, so I'm just going to delete all of the cards that they've created for me. Hit the three dots and then select delete. We can always drag these columns and hide any of the columns that we don't want to see. For now, I'm going to hide no status. Now for the property of this page, I don't think I need the tags one, so I'm going to delete that property. And we can also rename this template to anything that we want it to be. And now if we go back and back again to the page for today, we will see the to-do list template. And we can hit on that to directly create a to-do list. And now we don't have to adjust things around to make it the way that we want it to be. Now we can just add new cards and then put in whatever we need to do for today. We can also click any of the cards to open it up as a new page and then take notes in it. We can also drag cards around to indicate different status of these tasks, just like this. And now if we go back to the original calendar, if we add a new page to a different date, we can also use the to-do list that we created before. So the template that we created can be used across every single page in this calendar.
And there's a lot more on Notion that you can do. Just use your creativity. And I'd also like to thank Notion for sponsoring today's video. Again, Notion is free to use, so feel free to try it out using the link in the description below. And let me know what you want to see from my channel in the future. Have fun and have a great day. The camera is too far to reach this time, so I'm just gonna walk here and then see you next time.